What do you do? Where do you go to work? What car do you drive? How do you thrive? Where do you go to church? When the lights go down, how do you get down? I want to know how you twerk. Do you have money? Or are you broke? Out of curiosity. It's about money, power, status, and fame. Open your eyes and see. I'm a respecter of persons. Oh, I don't care what your worth is. I'm a respecter of persons. Oh yeah, it's all about the appearances. La 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 la. Oh, please stop. Shut up, shut up, shut up, shut up, shut up, shut up, shut up. Shut up. Quiet the noise. Silence the voices. Stop the judgment and put down your measuring stick. I am so tired of all of these crazy voices and all of these wild expectations we force ourselves into believing we must measure up to in order to be a valuable member of this society. Listen up, in part 3 now of Do It Unto God, it's titled, God is Not a Respecter of Persons. I want you to check out Romans chapter 2, verse 11, and it says, for there is no respecter of persons with God. God is not a respecter of persons. Sadly, a lot of people will judge you according to how you measure up to their values and expectations. For example, on the workplace, you could be sitting next to someone who knows you are below them. They may not even speak to you. They may turn their nose up at you and have an attitude with you because they don't believe there's anything you can do for them to help them get ahead. On the contrary, when people think that there's something you can do for them, or if you're in a position of power, they'll be extra nice to you, suck up to you, try to chat it up and do all these crazy things. I've come to tell you today, God is not a respecter of persons, and you don't have to be either. Don't let the way people treat you determine how you feel about yourself. The good news is that money, fame, power, and outward appearance don't mean anything to God. It doesn't dictate God's love for you. So no matter what you have or what you look like or where you are right now in life, there's nothing you can do to earn God's love. So find comfort in that, knowing that regardless of what the world says, regardless of what people think about you, God loves you so much, and God has already given you and poured out his love for you by sending his only son. Erase the blurred lines of how you look at yourself and how you determine your self-worth. Once again, status, money, all of these things we aspire for, that doesn't determine your soul and your spirit and who you are. And most importantly, these blurred lines of worldly things don't determine your authority in God and your position in the kingdom. Focus on who God has told you you are and who God has called you to be. And when you focus on these things, you will wake up every day feeling valuable, knowing who you are in the kingdom, knowing that whatever you ask in Jesus' name will be given to you. So get rid of all of this stuff. Throw it out of the window, because God is not a respecter of persons. And the number 3 thing I want you to take away from part 3 of Do It Unto God is take your focus off of man. Because when you're focused on man, even though it seems like, oh, I gotta know what the celebrities are wearing, I gotta know where I need to be and to be seen to drive this car and blah, 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 you're really boxing yourself in and putting a limit on what God has for you. What if God doesn't have any of that for you? He can't open up the windows of heaven and pour out what he does have because you're so busy looking at external things that God doesn't have for you right now anyway. So focus on God and not man. When you focus on God's purpose and God's vision for your blessed life, he is going to bless you. And I believe that this is a season of miracles for people. When you focus on God, God can bless you right now where you are doing what you're doing. Just keep doing it unto God. Take your focus off of man. God is not a respecter of persons. Don't think that you're less than because of what you have or what you don't have. God is going to bless you. I can't wait to bring you part 4. Because I'm going to be talking about David, and he has such a perfect story and is the perfect example of being raised up. So just stay strong, hang in there. I love you. God loves you. I want you to keep your head up, focus on your worth and who you are in God, and believe that God is opening doors for you. Because I'm talking to the person who's been looked down upon and who's been feeling down and out because of where they are right now. And I just want to speak life to you and let you know that these hard times don't last always. And God is going to bless you for your obedience, for your sacrifice, for your service, and for keeping a good attitude. And right now, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, I thank you for this opportunity, Lord God, to speak to your people, Lord God. I ask, God, that you would shake out, God, shake out these mentalities from our minds, Lord God, of being less than God and being discouraged, Lord God. Give us joy in this season, Father God. Open doors of opportunity, Lord God. Open, Lord God, the windows of heaven, Lord God. Bless your people, Lord God. Set the captives free right now in the name of Jesus. Thank you for watching another rocking episode of Faith Rocks on national television. I'll be back next week with part 4. Bye.